All right. All of you open notebooks in front of you and give the heading case study. पेज ले लो, किसी से कोई बात नहीं है। गिव द हेडिंग केस स्टडीज। ऑनलाइन क्लास यू ऑल्सो ओपन द नोटबुक एंड गिव द हेडिंग्स केस स्टडीज।
बी क्वाइट, रिकॉर्डिंग ऑन है।
All right. One slide is displayed on the projector in front of you. This will be your first topic of case study. And I'll be asking question. You are to write the answers in your notebook. Okay. It may or may not be in the MCQ form. It may be one word. It may be one sentence. Right. First question is, what do we call the rules for acceptable online behavior? What do we call the rules for acceptable online behavior? Netiquettes. You can give the numbering, first case study, second case study, third case study, like this. This is first case study. Yes. So our first answer is netiquettes. All right. What is another name for netiquettes? What is another name for netiquettes? Network etiquettes. Network etiquettes. The word netiquettes has been derived from which two words? Network and etiquettes. Network and etiquettes. All right, from the given statements, which is not a proper guideline of netiquettes? Be aware of what you post online. Be careful of what you say. Be mindful of privacy. Share your OTP with others. Share your OTP with others. This is not a proper guideline for netiquettes. We must never share our OTP with others. Right? Second case study, your topic is e-commerce. All right, full form of e-commerce, electronic commerce. One general question, name any two mode of payment online, by using debit card, by using credit card. What else? Paytm. Paytm. Net banking. UPI. All right. What is privacy? Protect protection of personal information online. When we are to protect our personal information online, that is called privacy. All right. In order to safeguard our privacy, in order to safeguard our personal information, which practice must not be followed? Your options are: the seller or merchant must ensure that user has gone through terms and conditions. The seller must clearly state how user data will be used. Seller must not disclose every term and condition to the buyer. The user and buyer must go through terms and conditions. The seller must not disclose all terms and conditions to the buyer. This statement is not valid with respect to safeguard of personal information. All right. Moving further. All right. Next case study. Your topic is fraud. Name two dangerous type of frauds. First, go through the case study. Read the case study, then answer your questions. I said, read the case study thoroughly, then answer the questions. Nahi dikh raha. Sur uthao. Utho. Batata. Recording on. Stool uthao. Stool uthaiye, please. Udhar aajao. Aajao. निकलो आजो निकलो चलो उधर बैठ जाओ. यस गुड. सो व्हाट आर द टू डेंजरस टाइप ऑफ फ्रॉड्स? स्टीलिंग इंफॉर्मेशन एंड फ्रॉडुलेंट पेमेंट्स. व्हिच आर नॉट सो डेंजरस एंड कैन बी रिकवर्ड? नॉन डिलीवरी ऑफ गुड्स, non-existing companies. Okay, clear? All right, how can you resolve the online fraud? How can you resolve the online fraud? By setting up the official bodies who will check the existence of the companies, okay, and promising the user about delivery of goods. All right, when someone steals your personal information, what type of fraud occurs? Identity theft. When credit card information gets stolen, which fraud occurs? Credit card fraud. All right. Which of the following measures is invalid to prevent fraud? A monitoring official body that ensures the sanctity of the commerce, strong security mechanism, secure payment methods, sharing of OTP with friend. Sharing of OTP with friend. Sharing of OTP with friend. All right. Which two special security techniques must be visible in order to access the website. एक तो प्रोटोकॉल HTTPS होना चाहिए, सेकेंड पैडलॉक साइन, सेकेंड इज पैडलॉक साइन. वन इज योर प्रोटोकॉल शुड बी HTTPS, सेकेंडली यू मस्ट हैव अ पैडलॉक साइन. सेकेंड इंस्ट्रक्शन रीड करो. Am I clear? All right. What does HTTP signifies? HTTP. Not a secure connection. What does HTTPS signifies? Secure connection. You are under a secure connection. All right. What does letter S in HTTPS stands for? Secure. All right. Next case study is secure data transmission. Your next case study is secure data transmission. What is the first of all, go through the case study. I give you 2 minutes, all of you in your mind, read the case study, complete case study. Aapko dikh rahi hai PPT? The term refers to applying enough technical safeguards so that data travels safely to its target without being compromised and eavesdrop. Following techniques are used: SSL, data encryption, use safe protocols. My first question is, what is the term given to applying enough technical safeguards so that data is not compromised? Secure data transmission. Pick the odd one out. SSL, data encryption, use safe protocols, IPR. First three are the ways to provide secure data transmission. Fourth one is not a valid technique. Okay. All right. SSL stands for secure socket layer. Secure socket layer. Okay, name the standard security protocol that provides encrypted link between sender and the buyer. SSL, secure socket layer. All right. It is a technique by which the original message is converted into cipher text. Data encryption. What do we call the code in which original message is converted? जिस कोड में उसको कन्वर्ट करते हैं उस टेक्निक को क्या कहते हैं? सिफर टेक्स्ट, दैट इज कॉल्ड सिफर टेक्स्ट, सी आई पी एच ई आर, सी आई पी एच ई आर टेक्स्ट, टी ई एक्स टी. The code in which your original message is converted is called ciphertext. What is the technique to convert ciphertext back into original? Decryption. All right. Moving further, IPR. What does P in IPR stands for? Property. R? I? All right. Now go through this case study. I give you 2 minutes. All of you go through the case study minutely. Then I start with the questions. Shall we start?
Yes, sir.
What do we call the right of owner of information to decide in how much information to be exchanged? IPR. In how many ways, IPR rights can be protected? 3, 4, 5, or 6? Soch lo. 3. What are those 3 ways? Patent, copyright, trademark. Patent, copyright, trademark. What are the rights called which are given for given to inventor for his invention? Patent. Patent rights are always given on invented work. Okay, what are the rights given to the creator of artistic, literary, or intellectual work? Copyright. Copyright. What do we call the registered symbol or logo that uniquely identify the product? Trademark. Okay, do you know what is the time period of trademark? 10 years. 10 years. After expiry of 10 years, you have to get it renewed. So please note it down. 10 years is the time period of trademark. Pick the odd one out. Patent, copyright, trademark, SSL. SSL. The right given for artistic creative work is copyright. True or false? Bolo. True or false? True. Next case study, topic is plagiarism. Go through the case study. All of you go through the case study minutely. Done. Stealing of somebody else's work and presenting it as its own. Plagiarism. जैसे यहां प्लानिंग चल रही है ना कि प्रोजेक्ट का एक पेज किसी और से लेंगे, एक किसी और से लेंगे, एक किसी और से लेंगे और सर को फाइल दे देंगे. Clear? So you are not to indulge into plagiarism. And no planning of taking separate pages from separate students. All right. Which of the following situation is not a plagiarism? First is using some author's work without giving credit, modifying someone's production without attributing, giving incorrect source of information, copying the answer from friend notebook with his consent. Copying the answer from friend notebook with his consent is known as, is not a plagiarism. आपके friend ने अपनी मर्जी से आपको permission दी कि answer note down करो. That is not counted as plagiarism. All right. Pick out the statement which signifies how to prevent or avoid plagiarism. Okay. Do not cite the source. Do not include any quotations. Paraphrase and present the idea. Avoid using plagiarism checker. Paraphrase and present the idea. Okay? Clear? Next case study. Japleen, Saket, अभी तक क्लियर है सब टॉपिक्स? ऑनलाइन स्टूडेंट्स ऑल राइट इन द एब्रीविएशन DPR व्हाट डज पी स्टैंड्स फॉर डी डिजिटल State two relevant examples of DPR. Social media. इतने example दिए हुए हैं देखो. Social media account, personal account, any shopping account, video games account. All right. Two threats to DPR. Penetration tools, stealing and plagiarizing the codes. Penetration tools, stealing and plagiarizing the codes. All right, I close this PPT and I open the next PPT. All right. Open source licenses. Go through the case study, then I start the questions. Yes. All right. As per the reading of the case study, what are your views about the use of license, the benefit of license? According to your views, don't copy answer from case study. What are your views about the benefit of license? Yes, Imani, what are your views? जनरल बताओ व्यूज अपने, डोंट ब्लाइंडली रीड फ्रॉम द केस स्टडी. व्हाट आर योर व्यूज? लाइसेंस के हमें क्या बेनिफिट मिलते हैं? वी कैन फ्रीली यूज द सॉफ्टवेयर. ओके राहुल, वी कैन इजिली शेयर डिस्ट्रीब्यूट. आप बताओ. We can modify it. Okay. All right. वायर लूज होगी, होगी नो प्रॉब्लम. व्हाट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ जीपीएल? जीएनयू, ग्नू नॉट यूनिक्स. ग्नू नॉट यूनिक्स. ऑल राइट. व्हाट आर द वेरियस राइट्स गिवन अंडर जीपीएल? व्हाट आर द वेरियस राइट्स? फ्रीली शेयर्ड. Freely modifiable, distribute, freely share. All right. What is the full form of lesser GPL? Lesser general public license. Okay. Two type of BSD license. One is modified or new BSD. Second is simplified BSD. What is the full form of BSD license? Berkeley Software Distribution. Which license is known as the family of permissive licenses? BSD licenses. What is the full form of MIT license? Massachusetts Institute of Technology. Massachusetts Institute of Technology. All right. Which license is considered to be the least restrictive license? MIT. Which is very loose? MIT. All right. What are the various rights provided under Apache license? Rights are perpetual. Rights are worldwide. Rights are granted for no fees or royalty. Rights are non-exclusive. Rights are irrevocable. Okay. Mask hi karo apna. All right. Now, next case study is your FOI. FOI, that is freedom of information. All right. Now listen to the questions. Thoda aage jao aap. थोड़ा आगे शिफ्ट करो अपना स्टूल, थोड़ा और आगे करो. All right, listen the questions carefully now. In the abbreviation FOI, what does F stands for? Freedom. The gap between the individuals who have the right to access technology and who do not have the right to access. What is that gap called? Yes, please hurry up, tell me. The gap between the individuals who have the access to technology and who do not have the access. I give four options. FOI, digital unity, digital divide, GPL. Digital divide. And if there is equal sharing of technology and resources, what is that called? Digital unity. If resources are equally divided, that is digital unity. If resources are unequal, that is digital divide. Okay. What are the various purpose of FOI? Read from the case study and let me know the answer. Transparency, government accountability, education, general public protection. All right. This is your digital divide. Just I discussed the gap between the individuals who have access and who do not have access to, or if they have the access, they have limited access. Okay, that is digital divide, right? So your revision test 2 syllabus is revised, case studies are revised. Okay, thank you class for coming online. अभी मैंने उठने को नहीं कहा.